I'm Miss Avra, and now I will present about the effect of social media on mental health. Social media has a big impact on someone's life, because on this day, we use social media for many things. As a human being, we have to use social media circumspect, which means we have to use it carefully and wisely, because social media can bring a good or a bad impact in our life. It becomes a stigma in our life. These are some facts about this topic. First one, Professor of Physiology in San Diego State University discovered that teens who spend online 5 or more hours have a 71% risk of suicide. And the second one, Indonesia Family Life Survey found out that social media is really dangerous for mental health and it's increasing someone's CEDD social score 9%. Organisms that being affected because of social media are of course human, because it can affect the ability of making decisions, our problem, and giving a bad impact in sleeping time, and causing someone has trouble in communication because there's something trouble in the brain. However, social media can bring a good impact. For example, it can encourage many people to keep the, our environment. And it's a quick way to spread helping news in the dangerous situation. But the bad side, the news can be exaggerated and make many people panic. And the next one, because social media, many people right now make a beauty standard in our environment. The pros of using social media, the first one is raising our awareness. For example, just like important issue that happening right now about corona. And the second one, it can eliminate our loneliness because through social media, we can interact with many people. And the third one, we can get many information. And the fourth one, we can maintain our relationship with many people. The cons of using social media are, it can promoting many fake news. And then the second one, it can increase loneliness because through social media, it can reduce our time socializing with other face-to-face. And because of that reason, it encourages anti-social behavior. And the last one is cyberbullying. In Arizona, there's a 15-year-old boy who killed his own father because his father banned him from using social media called MySpace. And I believe this type of case is happening around the world right now. And indicates that social media makes someone do sadistic things and it's affecting on mental health. But now there's like some organization who can help people like him. Two of them are NIH and Into the Light. These two organizations help to prevent and cure mental illness that caused by social media. They do clinical research, counseling, and campaign activity. My opinion, what can be done in the future is I hope that many rehabilitation and organization are more focused and dealing with this human issue. And make sure that many people, especially teenagers, know that there's an organization where they can find the right help. And the second one, the government can make more tighter regulation of the usage of social media. And the last one is the accuracy of social media data user. For example, the government should make regulation to make an identity card that work on with any social media platform, so the information about age cannot be falsified, because age is really influential in social media life. And now, how do we as a teenager can get involved and contribute into these human cases? The first one, you have to control social media so that social media cannot control our life. And the second one, we can get involved into organization or helping other people or our friend who have mental illness because of social media. And the third one, we have having filter in our mind for any information that we get. And the last one, through our social media we have, we can share our inspiration or motivation about life. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope after you listening to this presentation, you know the impact of social media and use it carefully and wisely. God bless you.